Welcome to the Vector Garden. In this quick tip, we're going to create an ink-like drawing, such as this. I have prepared the drawing that we now need to somewhat put some effects to and make some additions. So first of all, I need something that looks like an ink splash. So with the pencil tool, I'm just going to draw something like this. And there is a width profile applied that I'm going to delete. And also let's just switch fill and stroke. And then this is gone, like this. And then we need to make a brush out of that. So let's go to the brushes panel and just drag that inside of here, make a scatter brush, and let's set them all to random, like this. And I'm just going to edit the settings like this. And we might need to adjust that later on. So let's just set it up like this. And here we're going to use tints. Okay. So that's this. And this can be deleted. And then we're going to prepare this one as well. And this actually gets a width profile applied. But we're going to edit that using the width tool. So we're going to make this thicker in some places, but thinner in others. Just like you feel that this should look, and just apply that. And in some places, maybe rather thick. So that's when the pen has been pressed on the paper really hard. And maybe it could get thinner here, but thicker in this place and here as well. And here it gets thinner. Let's take a look at these here. Like this. And I want it thinner here. And hair as well, a little thicker hair. The corners are always a little difficult because Illustrator sets width point in corners automatically and you need to adjust them like this. So this is the base drawing. And then let's also select all of that. Let's go to the appearance panel. We need to do that for every one separately. So let's make an additional stroke and apply that brush to it. And the same with these two. So an additional stroke and that brush. And here as well, like this. Maybe it's a little too blotchy, so let's go in here, double click that and set the spacing with more space in that, like this. So now we need that inky look, and that we're going to apply to the layer. So let's go to Window Layers, and in the layers, let's target that layer. So now the styles get applied to the layer, which means when later on you draw some more, then the styles get applied to that automatically. What we need first is Effect Path Outline Stroke. That doesn't change anything in the look, but everything in how Illustrator treats that. It's now a shape. So the next thing is we're going to roughen that. So let's go to Distort and Transform and roughen. And you see, this might not be what we want here, but it looks interesting. So I'm just going to OK. Rather needs to be applied after outline stroke. And then let's go into it and set it to smooth. And also the size needs to be smaller. And the detail needs to be more. And I'm going to set this to absolute because we have longer and we have shorter lines. So it needs to be set to absolute so that they look identical. And let's take a look at the size, but that is quite a lot. So more detail so that we get these uneven strokes like this and make this smaller. So I'm setting this to 0.4 like this. So we have a nice uneven look about them. The next thing is we need that it gets lighter in the center. So like ink does it. It flows to the outside and in the center it gets lighter. So let's go to Effect, Stylize, and we need some inner glow like this. And let's go to OK. That's the correct place. And we're going to set a smaller blur, but a higher opacity until this shows. And maybe we can also experiment with the color like this. And you see, we get a slight look of that inside. And if we set an even smaller amount of blur, then we get exactly what we want. You can also experiment with the modes, the blend modes, and see if we get a nicer result using that. And maybe we can reduce this here as well. And then we can also experiment with the blur again, and then we need that darker. And you see, you can balance that the way you want it to look. Like this maybe for bluish ink. And then what you get is also nice because this inner glow only shows in places where the stroke is very thick. In other places, you don't really see it. So that's actually kind of coming nearer to the effect we want to have, so to the analog effect of this. And also you can overlay it on a piece of paper that you place behind this and maybe set the whole layer to multiply as well. So you could go in here into the layer and set the opacity to multiply and then put that on a nice piece of scanned paper to come even closer to that look.